the economy and the environment here in Yarmouth. Certainly as a journalist for over 20 years, you've done many stories and many investigations of various aspects of the economic story. We all know that Yarmouth has declined over the last 20 years. So how do you see that situation and how do you see a resolve for that?
Well, I guess you only have to walk down Main Street to recognize that Yarmouth is in decline at the moment. I can think back to 1985, 1988, when Yarmouth was booming. Our census was actually going up, our population was actually going up instead of going down, which it is now. And we were starting to attract young families back to this area. In the last 15 to 20 years, we've lost so much. Not only have we lost major industries like Dominion Textile and Rio Algum, can't really control those things. You know, those are a factor of corporate control that really isn't within our jurisdiction. But there are other things that have happened, things that the government has been responsible for, like the consolidation of services towards the center of the province. If you don't live in Truro, Bridgewater, or Kentville, you are not going to you're not going to see services anymore like we used to see here. And that's a concern because the costs of having to travel to secure services are one of the things that are impediments for people moving here. But, you know, there are things you can control and things you can't control. I know that the downtown is suffering right now, but I believe that as a community, we can support the downtown through a local initiative. We can support all of our artisans, we can support our local food producers. We have a local food movement that's growing in momentum here, and it's a wonderful thing to support. But beyond the local food movement is a whole movement to shift just a little bit of our income back towards the local economy. You know, statistics will tell you that if you shop in a box store, big box store, perhaps $2 of every 10 will recirculate into the local economy. But if you support a local operator, probably $6 to $8 will circulate in the local economy. You know, we could grow jobs here without ever having any further investment in the community, just by making that switch and just consciously thinking about where we're purchasing our goods and services. Doesn't mean that we never shop at a box store again. It means that we try to divert just a little bit of it. And there are case studies throughout North America that show how dramatic that effect can be. And it's something that we can do here locally. It just takes cooperation and awareness. Thank you.